Greetings everyone. Today I am going to show you three famous QVAN image edit LoRAs that you have been hearing of. For example, we have this image. First, I will show how to remove its background with highest quality. We have a tool for that. Then you have this background and you just copy paste it like this with the size like this. It is just a copy paste. Then with this QVAN image fusion LoRa, you will be able to fuse image into scene like this, any image. It can be a product, it can be something else. The second LoRa that I am going to show you is QVAN image relight. So we have this base image, you see, this is its natural lighting, and you will be able to relight it into any lighting as you wish. It can be product, it can be item, it can be person, whatever you like. The third famous LoRa is the angle changing, camera angle changing LoRa. So we will give our input image like this and we will be able to get different angle outputs like this as we wish. You can do this for person, for items, for products, whichever you want. I'm going to show you all of them how to do in Swarm UI with the easiest way with our presets. So as in our previous tutorials, download our latest Swarm UI model downloader zip file. The link will be in the description of the video. Put it into your Swarm UI installation and extract it and overwrite all the files like I am doing. Then start Windows Start Download Models app file like this. Run. Then in the Swarm UI bundles, you will see there are three new LoRAs. QVAN Image Edit Multiple Angles LoRa, QVAN Image Edit Relight LoRa, and QVAN Image Edit Fusion LoRa. You can just download the image downloading bundle from here, or you can download QVAN Image Core bundle from here, or you can manually download each one of them. They are positioned under the Image Generation Models, QVAN Image Editing Models, and in here you will see we have QVAN Image Relight LoRa, Fusion LoRa, and Multiple Angles LoRa. Moreover, we have a search feature, so let's collapse all Swarm UI bundles and copy the name like Relight LoRa, paste it into search bar, and you will get directly the LoRa link like this. So click download, Multiple Angles LoRa, search, you see here, click download and Fusion LoRa, search and click download. As a next step, you need to have new presets. So as usual, you can import presets from choose file and overwrite, or you can use our Windows preset delete import. This will back up your existing presets and delete all of them and import and add the new presets. You need to have Swarm UI running for this to work. So it will ask you, click yes, and it is done. Then refresh your presets, sort by name, and you will have the latest presets. So let's begin with the first Fusion LoRa. I will first refresh my page, reset params to default, this is important. Then I am going to use this preset, QVAN Image Edit Plus 12 Steps. This is for QVAN Image Editing Models, Editing Tasks. Direct apply. And in addition to this preset, I need to select QVAN Fusion LoRa. You see, this is the QVAN Fusion LoRa. I select it like this. Now, this LoRa has a description that you need to follow. Click here, edit metadata. And in the bottom, you will see that there is description prompt. So copy this prompt. So you can copy this entirely, paste it into any text file and copy the prompt from here. This is the prompt they trained this LoRa. Then for fusion, you need to have two images that you want to fuse and you need to remove background. For removing the background, we have BriefNet HR, High Resolution Background Remover. This application is the most powerful background removing application. I have recently updated it, download its latest zip file, paste it into any disk, wherever you want, extract. Then Windows install or update and run. This model is really, really powerful. This will automatically install. It is same as in our other applications. We have RunPod and Mass Compute installers as well. So if you didn't watch our previous Swarm UI and Conf UI backend tutorials, this is the tutorial that you need to watch. This will show you how to install Swarm UI and Conf UI as a backend and use it with our presets, with image generation, And this tutorial is for RAMPOD and mass compute. If you don't have a powerful GPU, you can watch this tutorial to learn how to install SwarmUI and ConfUI and use. So this is for Windows and this is for cloud. They are fully up-to-date, very recent videos. For removing backgrounds, of course, you can use other applications as well, but I am preferring BriefNet HR because this is the most powerful background remover I have seen. So the installation has been completed. You can scroll up and quickly check the logs. Our installers, all of them supports RTX 5000 series as well, or the cloud GPUs like H100, B200, RTX 6000 Pro on Windows and Linux, both of them. So after installation, start the application like this. This application uses VRAM directly related to your input image resolution. So as your input image resolution is bigger, it will use more VRAM. So to upload your image, click here and select your image. Then there are resolution presets, as you can see. You may be wondering which one is best. So you can compare each case. Default is 2048 to 2048. Depending on your input image resolution, it will use more VRAM or not, and it will impact the output slightly. I have a comparison link here. You can see the comparison of different input images. For example, this is input image. This is the original size remove. So you can see like this, original size remove doesn't change the input image resolution when processing, or we have 2048 to 2048 resolution like this. So which one is better? I think the original is a little bit better perhaps. I don't know, it depends on each image, so you can try. Okay, I got error with 4000 pixels for this image. This image was really big. Let's see if I am using a lot of VRAM right now. So let's try with 2048 pixels, process image. If you get out of VRAM error like this, you should reduce the resolution of your input image or the processing resolution and pay attention to your VRAM usage. If it uses the shared VRAM, it will be really slow. By the way, since I have had out of VRAM error, I need to restart the application. So it will clear the VRAM. Yes, it is now cleared. Okay, I don't need to change. Oh, it already had worked actually. So you see, this was our input image. You can see it perfectly removes the background. Now I have my background removed image, and I have another image where I want to merge it. So let's copy this image, and I'm using paint.net. This is a free tool. Add a new layer like this and paste it. So then I will resize it like this, base it on the resolution that I want to put it, base it on the, you know, the related aspect ratio or the related resolution like this, or the size we can say. Then I am going to merge this. Then I will save as to use. Let's save it into our downloads folder, wherever you want, and maximum quality. So this resolution is really big. The Qwen image edit models doesn't support this big resolution, but you can try. First of all, you need to use this plus icon to upload prompt image. This is how Qwen image models works, if you remember. Then to get the accurate aspect ratio, I'm going to use a simple trick. So choose image, download, resolution, use closest aspect ratio, and it is done. Then I will do something else as well. You see, there is smart image prompt resizing. You should compare results with this is on and off, because this makes impact. So let's generate 4 images, because you should generate multiple images to see the actual quality. And it is generating right now. This will be fairly fast because this preset is only 12 steps. Okay, you see it is generating right now. It is fully utilizing my GPU. This is great. And if you don't have a powerful GPU, it will automatically do block swapping and it will still work. This is the beauty of SwarmUI, which uses the ConfUI as a backend. And you see, we are fully supporting Sage Attention as well on all GPUs. And we are also using the Qwen Image Edit Plus FP8 scaled version. I have prepared everything, fully optimized for you guys. And we have our images. You see, it has fused image into it pretty accurately, with shadows and everything. It is looking much more natural. Then, for example, let's reuse parameters of this image, and I'm going to upload prompt image again because it is gone like this, and I'm going to change this. Let's see what happens. As I said, you should try and see if it makes difference, if it improves or not. This smart image prompt resizing changes the scale of the input image according to the Qwen image edit model. You see, it says it is almost always best to leave this on, but in some cases, if you are setting your resolution accurately, you may turn it off. Okay, so this is another image. Let's make a comparison. This to this. I don't know, both is looking really good. So it is up to you. You can test it and see. So this was the first case. Now, the next case. Let's refresh this page. Reset params to default to not make any mistakes. Presets. Again, I am going to use this Qwen Image Edit Plus preset. Then the next LoRa that I'm going to show you is Relight. So I am selecting this Relight LoRa. And when I edit metadata and copy its description and paste it here, you see this is the prompt. So we are going to use this trigger word and paste it. Then we will select our Relight LoRa image from here as usual. You can also drag and drop. Let me show you, for example, this image. And you see now it is image prompting. Then let's generate four images. This is going to relight it into sunlight. Again, you need to set resolution accordingly to keep the aspect ratio accurately. So I will init image and I will select the image from here. I will say use closed aspect ratio, then you turn this off. If you don't turn this off, it will not work. So this is init image, this is image prompting. They are totally different. And generate. Now let's see the results. Again, we are using 12 steps. This resolution is like 2 megapixels, so it is fairly fast. Okay, it is generating right now. This is the VRAM usage, but don't worry about VRAM usages. It works as low as 6 GB GPUs if you have sufficient amount of RAM memory. Even if you don't have, it will work, but it will be slow. And here it is relighted into sunlight. Very good. I mean, from this input image, you see, this was a very big image, to this image. So you can play with it. You can even try higher resolution and see if it is working. If you use higher resolution, of course, it will use more VRAM. It will take more time. It is up to you, but try it. The third case is, let's refresh, reset params to default, and select our preset one more time. We are all using this Qwen image edit preset, and hopefully Qwen image 2511 is coming, which will be an upgrade, and I will upgrade it as soon as arrive it, hopefully. The next LoRa is multiple angles LoRa, and again, edit metadata, copy the description to have the prompts. So there are some example prompts like move the camera front, left, right. Let's see the turn the camera to a top-down view and copy paste it here. Again, we are going to use a prompt image. So let's use this one. Again, you need to have accurate aspect ratio. This is very close to 16 by 9. So since I know its aspect ratio, I can make it like this and 4. But you know the strategy right now. And let's see the result. I have spent huge time to prepare these presets, edit these LoRAs, add accurate information, add to our downloader. All of these are taking huge time. And furthermore, I am right now working on updated Flux configurations. You will love them. We have got huge amount of improvements. Let me show you. So our new configurations will be shared. And let me show you the new speeds. We have got huge speed up. We have added torch compile. This was not available in ST scripts. Now I am improving it. I have my own copy. So we are now using both ST scripts and Kohya GUI developed by me. So we have torch compile. It is working great. It is working even great with multiple GPU now. So you can get up to 4x speed up with 4 GPUs if you use this is for Dreamboot fine tuning. And we have new LoRa configs, and when you open that, you will see. And when we see its speed, it is like this. This is great speed. Again, 4x GPU is working. So hopefully I will make a quick tutorial for it as well. And you can watch our older tutorials. So search in our channel like this. And you see, you can watch this tutorial to use our newest presets. But I will show quickly as well. in a newer tutorial. Still, you should watch it. Okay, we got our new angle. So this is a top-down view angle generations it has made based on our input image. So this was our input image, and based on this input image, we have got top-down views. So you can again use this on humans, animals, items, products, whichever you want. It should work fairly well. This was the Laura that you have been seeing on the social media, Reddit, about the multiple angles Laura. So these three Lauras are the newest Qwen image edit Lauras that you have been hearing on. I hope you have enjoyed. You can ask many questions from Patreon, from YouTube, from Discord. Hopefully see you in another amazing tutorial video.